So hello guys, welcome and welcome back to our channel. So today we will discuss one more question from CSIR Physics. So as you can see, this is the question which says a hollow waveguide supports transverse electric field TE modes with dispersion relation K is equal to 1 by C under root omega square minus omega mn square, where omega mn is the mode frequency. And the question is to find out the speed of flow of electromagnetic energy at the mode frequency. Okay, so these are the four options. So before going to this question, I have already uploaded one video related to this TE, transverse electric and transverse magnetic modes of the waveguide, and a little bit information about this waveguide. So basically this waveguide is nothing but a metallic hollow pipe kind of thing, and in through which we transverse the information in the form of electromagnetic waves. So in that there is a rigorous mathematical analysis for this waveguide, through which, like we know, in this case we have to consider, if you guys have studied this waveguide part, I am not going much deeper. So just we know that you have to include the longitudinal components here, that is EZ and BZ. So if the Z component of the electric field is zero, we say that is a TE mode. And if the magnetic Z component of the magnetic field is zero, we say that is a TM mode, or that is transverse magnetic mode. So, and if both EZ and BZ are zero, then we call them TEM mode. So that is a mixed kind of thing. Okay, so as we are interested in case of waveguide, regarding the propagation of a monochromatic wave in the tube, like this waveguide is nothing but a kind of tube. So, and we know that E and B have the generic form in the exponential form. We know that E naught e to the power I k z minus omega t, and B in terms of B naught e to the power I k z minus omega t. And this waveguide is nothing but a conductor. So we have to consider the propagation of electromagnetic wave inside a conductor. Like this we have to proceed. And as the E naught and B naught, they have the longitudinal components also. So we have to they are not in general transverse, but we have to consider the longitudinal components also. So when we are saying TE mode, actually if we are saying TE mode, like there is electric field, magnetic field, and electric field and magnetic field are there. Like if I am saying, as we have already discussed these things in one video is there in our channel. So if the wave is propagated along this direction, this is the electric field, and this is the, let this be the magnetic field. So we know three are perpendicular to each other. So if we'll consider the, if we resolve this electric field and magnetic field, if this is E, this is B, and this is the propagation of the direction of propagation of the wave, electromagnetic wave. So if the Z component, like if after resolving this electric field and this magnetic field, just I am giving a rough area of idea about this propagation. So if EZ is equal to zero, we say that this is a TE mode. Okay, so EZ is zero, but EX, EY are not equal to zero. So if BZ is equal to zero, that is Z components, you can see if the Z components are zero, that is depending on the Depending on this jet components, we like named these as T mode and TM mode. Okay. So if B is equal to 0, we are saying that this is TM mode. T transverse magnetic, and this indicates transverse electric mode. Okay. So this after the rigorous considering the electric field and magnetic field and this E naught have components along the three directions like EX, EY and EZ, BX, BY and BZ, if I'll go a little bit earlier to this thing, we see this E, we know that E is equal to E naught e to the power I kz minus omega t. Similarly, let this be traveling along, we know that this is traveling along the z axis, and b is equal to b naught e to the power I kz minus omega t. So this components like this e naught is having components along x, along y, along z. And the same thing goes for the B also. So from this, if E is equal to 0, we are saying T mode. And similarly, if the here we will get B Z Z cap, we will get B Y Y cap, and here X cap B X and B naught. So if B Z becomes 0, we will get T M mode. So after putting this in the Maxwell's equation and rearranging this, we will get a equation. From there, we can calculate the two equations related to EZ and BZ. Okay, so I'm not going into that part. If you guys want to know in details like the derivation part and all, you can message me. So if you will DM me, then I can do that part in another video. Okay, so as we know, this wave vector, when I'm saying this, in considering this wave guide, so inside the wave guide, the wave is propagating with a frequency, right? So the frequency is like that frequency is let me do this part, okay? So the frequency at the frequency which the wave is traveling is like that is equal to, we know, 1 by under root mu e under root m pi by a mod square plus n pi by b mod square. Okay, this comes from this part. This is a rectangular waveguide. This is for rectangular waveguide. Okay. So these A and B are the this A and B are nothing but the width and widths of the height and width of the rectangular waveguide. Okay, so please refer to the video we have I have made earlier, so we'll get it clearly. Okay, so actually in this video I have already discussed things regarding this TE mode, TM mode and this frequency in another video, and just I am adding a bit to this waveguide, and you can get actually I am trying to give you the concepts. If I will solve this question, I will get it within 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, so basically thing is, this question, as it's saying, what is the, we have to consider the speed. Okay, so in the last video, if we'll refer to the one more video is there on our channel, you will get the idea about the frequency of the wave that is propagating inside the waveguide. And now this is asking about the speed of the flow of electromagnetic energy. So for the speed of the electromagnetic energy which is traveling inside a waveguide, so if I will consider that one, okay, so see, it is given that the wave number, the wave number k is equal to 1 by c under root omega square minus omega m n square, where we know that this omega n is the mode frequency, right? This is the mode frequency, and this mode frequency is given by this one. This is the formula. This is the mode frequency. Okay. This is the mode frequency. Okay. So, like it is asking the regarding the velocity. Okay. So we know that as this is a wave, for a wave, the wave is have two kind of things. One is phase velocity and one is group velocity. And see, we have already one video regarding this phase velocity and group velocity. Okay, so this phase velocity, if we calculate this phase velocity, we know that is equal to omega by k. So if we have omega, which is the angular frequency, so if we'll consider calculate omega by k, so we'll get here c by under root 1 by omega m n by omega square, because we have here k. We'll just substitute k here and we'll get 1 minus omega n by omega square over here. I hope you guys are getting these things. Okay, so if we'll consider the group velocity, that is d omega by dk. Okay, so we'll consider the group velocity because the question says that what will be the speed of flow of electromagnetic energy at the mode frequency. So we have to consider the speed of flow of the electromagnetic energy. If it, and for the speed, this is the wave velocity, but if we will consider the speed of the energy, so for that case we have to, like, the energy is carried by the wave, and that wave travels at the group velocity. Okay, energy carried by the wave travels at the group velocity, so you have to consider the group velocity, right? So if we'll go, I'm not going into this part. Okay, let me discuss regarding this one. So if I will see this part, there are conditions, like if you'll this is the omega mn is the mode frequency. Okay, so this mode, what is this mode frequency? This mode frequency is the, like, this is also, no, also it, this is known as the cutoff frequency. Okay, so this is the minimum frequency. Okay, below this frequency the wave cannot travel inside the waveguide. Okay, so this is the minimum frequency at which the wave propagates inside a waveguide. So this is the minimum frequency. Through which the wave propagates, or the wave can propagate inside the waveguide. Okay? Okay? So if the frequency, what will happen if frequency is the frequency is less than the cutoff frequency. So the for different kind of waveguide we have different cutoff frequency. Okay, so I will discuss this in later. So if we'll see, if omega is equal to, like, omega is less than omega mn, the cutoff frequency. Okay, what will happen here? If omega is less than omega n, as you can see here, we will get the minus, like 1 minus omega n by omega. So we will get a negative as a whole. Omega is less than, so this will be bigger than 1. So we will get a negative sign here. And after that, we will see, we can, here it will be imaginary. So the phase velocity will be imaginary. So if this will be imaginary, then the wave will not travel inside the, that what that indicates? That indicates the wave cannot travel inside the waveguide. Okay, if the omega is equal to omega mn, what will happen here? See, if omega is equal to omega n, the phase velocity, we'll see for the group velocity. Okay, the phase velocity will be equal to, see, this will be 1, so that will be c by 0, that will also equal to 0. And similarly, if we'll consider the case which is like the case when the wave will travel inside the propagate inside the waveguide is the case where this omega is greater than the omega mn. Okay, for this case, as we can see, if omega m omega is greater than omega mn, so this will be less than 1, and then for that case the phase velocity will be real. So in that case the wave will propagate inside the waveguide. Okay, so we'll jump to the question here. As we have seen, the question asks what will be the speed of the flow of electromagnetic energy at the mode frequency. Okay, so if Vp is equal to this much, okay, can we do this much? Okay, so let me, okay, so okay, so Vp is equal to omega by k, and we have Vg, that is the group velocity, which is the speed of that is the energy carried by the wave travels at the group velocity. So this is the group velocity at which the energy is carried by the wave. So Vg is equal to d omega by dk. So this is omega, we can write 1 by d omega by, sorry, dk by d omega. So if I'll do this one, we have k is equal to 1 by c under root omega square minus omega m n square. So dk by d omega will be equal to 1 by here 2c and here omega square minus omega m n square, and here we'll get 2 omega. Okay, so 2 gets cancelled, and by simplifying this we can see dk by d omega is equal to 1 by c, we'll take omega to the denominator, 1 minus omega mn square by omega square. Okay, so if I'll put this value here, so I'll get Vg is equal to c into 1 minus omega mn square by omega square. Okay, see, this group velocity is always less than equal to c, sorry, always less than c, this can't be greater than c. Okay, this is always less than c. Okay, so if I'll see, it is asking about the speed of the flow of energy. So as you can see, it is saying at mode frequency. The question is asking that we have what will be the speed at the mode frequency. So at mode frequency, this is omega mn is equal to omega. So omega mn is equal to omega, that means here we will get 1, and the Vg becomes, see, omega mn by omega, this will be 1, 1 minus 1 equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. So this is the velocity, like the, no, the velocity or the speed of the electromagnetic wave becomes 0 at the mode frequency. Okay, when the frequency is equal to the mode frequency, the speed becomes 0. That means the wave will not propagate at all. Okay, so the answer is, like, there is this is the answer. Okay, so this will be equal to 0. Actually, these are the things I am just I told to, like, for the purpose to recall the previous things. So that's why I just gave you little bit of idea about these things. And see, if we know these things, the phase velocity and group velocity, from there direct we can find out the answer. Okay, at omega mn. Okay, so we have k, and we know Vp is equal to omega by k, omega by k, and Vg is equal to d omega by dk, and I am giving you a direct without knowing about this TE mode and all, also you can find out these things. Okay, see, we have known about the we know about the group velocity and phase velocity. So the speed of flow of electromagnetic energy means we know that electromagnetic wave. So for a wave, a propagation of the wave, the speed is vg. So vg is equal to d omega by dk. So from here also we can find out the d omega by dk, and at mode frequency means at omega mn equal to omega. So we can, from here we can also find out the, like this is, this much is the this much is needed for this question. Vg is equal to 0. Okay then, so we'll see one more question in the next video. So thank you, take care, stay safe.